శ్రీ ముత్తవరపు వెంకటేశ్వర కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ 2008 లో స్థాపించిన కళాశాలలో ఎంబీఏ నాక్ ఏ గ్రేడ్ మరియు ఐఎస్ఓ సర్టిఫికేషన్ సాధించిన మొట్టమొదటి కళాశాల శ్రీ ముత్తవరపు వెంకటేశ్వర కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ త్వరలో ఎటోనోమస్ కాబోతుంది
2014 లో ఐఎస్ఓ గుర్తింపు 2015 లో రాష్ట్ర ప్రభుత్వం చే ఏ గ్రేడ్ 2016 లో నాక్ ఏ గ్రేడ్ ఇప్పుడు ఎంబీఏ సాధించిన సంస్థ శ్రీ ముత్తవరపు వెంకటేశ్వర కాలేజ్ ఆఫ్ ఇంజనీరింగ్ అండ్ టెక్నాలజీ
morning. So in the earlier classes we discussed about the Fourier transforms, how the Fourier transform is defined. It is the transformation of the Fourier series, that is if x of t is a continuous periodic signal, its a Fourier transform is x of omega. How these two are related we already discussed in our earlier classes, right? So that's why we can say that this x of t and x of omega are Fourier transform pair. These two are called Fourier transform pair, right? These two are called Fourier transform pair. See here we discussed about the periodic function and aperiodic function, relate how these two are related. So these two are related consider these two diagrams. This is a periodic signal and this is periodic signal. These two are related as a limit t naught tends to infinity xp of t equal to x of t, right? So from this expression we can derive the expressions for xp of t and x of t, or x of omega and x of t. So these two are called, see here the equation number 4 is nothing but the non-periodic signal in terms of the continuous sum of exponents, whereas x of omega is called frequency response. This is the continuous spectrum, frequency spectrum, or we can say that this is frequency spectrum and this is the periodic signal. So these two are called Fourier transform pair. So these two are referred as Fourier transform pair, and Fourier transform of x of t is x of omega, and inverse Fourier transform of x of omega is x of t. So these two are called x of t and x of omega, both are called Fourier transform pair, right? So next we will discuss about the Dirichlet conditions for Fourier transform. So already we discussed about the Dirichlet conditions for Fourier series. So what are the Dirichlet conditions for Fourier series? There we have three conditions are there. So first one is during the finite interval, that is minus infinity to infinity, x of t must be integral. X of t is absolutely integrable during the finite interval of time, right? So that is here also we have the same condition, that is integral minus n tends to t tends to, or we can say this is frequency response. That's why sigma n equal to minus infinity to infinity x of n dn is less than mod x of n dn is less than infinity. So here x of n is integrable, it is a finite integrable, it is integrable, right? So similarly it has a finite number of maximas and minimas within any finite interval. So same property is there for Fourier series also. So that is we have finite number of maximas and minimas within any finite interval. And third one is x of t have a finite number of discontinuities within any finite interval. Furthermore, each of the discontinuities must be finite. So here the discontinuities are also must be finite. So we have finite number of discontinuities within any finite finite interval, and these discontinuities should be finite. Okay, so x of t must be integrable. That means it is less than infinity, mod x of t dt is less than infinity. And the second one is a finite number of maximas and minimas, and the third one is a finite number of discontinuities within any finite interval. These three are called Dirichlet conditions for Fourier transform. Now we will see or we will solve some problems related to Fourier transform. See the first problem, find the continuous spectrum. Here continuous spectrum is x of omega or f of omega for the signal x of t, whether it is a periodic signal or non-periodic signal. That signal is given. If the signal is given, then we have to find out the continuous spectrum. In the sense, it is nothing but the Fourier transform. No doubt it is a Fourier transform. So some signal will be given, x of t or f of t, that is a periodic or non-periodic signal is given. We have to find its spectrum, means it is a Fourier transform. Okay, for the continuous spectrum for the signal, x of t is equal to e power minus a t u of t. For a is greater than 0, this is the given problem. Okay, this is the given problem. See here, u of t is the unit step function. How the unit step function is defined? Tell me. How the unit step function is defined? So u of t is equal to 1 for t is greater than or equal to 0. That means that for t is equal to 0 to infinity, its value is unity. Its value is unity, right? So u of t must be always 1 for t is greater than or equal to 0, right? So here it is, here the given function e of minus a t is multiplied with u of t for a is greater than 0, right? U of t is 1 for always t is greater than or equal to 0. But here a is greater than 0.
A, what is meant by a is greater than 0?
Here a is in between 0 and infinity. It means that a value is in between 0 to infinity, right? So now coming to solve the problem. Here the limits are from 0 to infinity. How to know that here the limits are from 0 to infinity? Why? Because here a is given as a is greater than 0. A is greater than 0 means it is varying from 0 to infinity. So that's why, depending upon the value of a, here the limits are also varying from 0 to plus infinity. So what is the formula for finding the Fourier transform or continuous spectrum of the non-periodic signal x of t, that is x of omega? X of omega is equal to Fourier transform of x of t. How to define this Fourier transform of x of t? That is defined by integral minus infinity to infinity x of t into e power minus j omega t dt. This is the formula for finding the Fourier transform of our signal x of t, right? So integral minus infinity to infinity x of t into e power minus j omega t dt, right? Okay, what is x of t here? That is e power minus a t into u of t. So integral minus infinity to infinity e power minus a t into u of t into e power minus j omega t dt. But we have to substitute the value of u of t here, right? So here u of t equal to 1 for t is greater than 0. So substitute u of t equal to 1 for t is greater than 0. T is greater than 0 means its limits are from 0 to infinity. But in our given problem, e power minus a t, so a is greater than 0. A is greater than 0 means here the limits are also from 0 to infinity. So we can adjust this limits from minus infinity to infinity to 0 to infinity. Okay. So here the limits are 0 to infinity e power minus a t into e power minus j omega t dt, right? Since u of t value is 1 for t is greater than 0, right? So it is in the form of e power x into e power y. E power x into e power y is nothing but e power x plus y. So we will add these powers. So e power minus of a minus j omega into a minus of minus, so that is plus a plus j omega into t dt. So here the limits are 0 to infinity only, 0 to infinity. So it is 1 by minus a plus j omega into e power minus of a plus j omega t in, with limits 0 infinity, right? By substituting the values of infinity and 0 in this expression, we will get the value of x of omega as 1 by a plus j omega for a is greater than 0, right? 1 by a plus j omega. Here e power minus infinity, see this one, this will become e power minus infinity. E power minus infinity is 1 by e power infinity. E power infinity is infinity. So 1 by infinity is 0. So this entire term will become 0. And this term will become e power 0. 0 minus 1. 0 minus 1? Minus 1. Minus into minus plus. So plus 1 by a plus j omega for a is greater than 0. Now we will draw the magnitude and phase spectrums like Fourier series. Like Fourier series. We also draw magnitude and phase spectrums in Fourier series. Like here also we will draw the magnitude and phase spectrums. Okay, now we will draw the magnitude spectrum first. So magnitude spectrum can be defined as mod of x of omega, that is 1 by square root of real term square plus imaginary term square, that is a square plus omega square. And phase angle theta equal to angle of x of omega, that is minus tan inverse imaginary term by real term, that is omega by a. After knowing the magnitude and phase expressions, we have to draw the magnitude spectrum and phase spectrum, right? Magnitude spectrum and phase spectrum, is it not? Okay, so now we will draw the magnitude spectrum and phase spectrums. See magnitude spectrum and phase spectrum. Okay, see here. So omega, first of all we have to tabulate the values of omega, magnitude and phase. Okay, here these are the magnitude omega values. Omega is minus infinity, a 0 plus a
plus infinity. Then substitute
these values in magnitude expression. Okay, this is the expression. So omega value is taken as minus infinity, minus a plus infinity, right? So substitute those values in this expression so that we will get magnitude. If it is minus infinity, it is 0, and theta is pi by 2. Like this, we will substitute these values in those expressions so that we will get the values like this. So by using these values, m versus frequency, we will get the spectrum like this. Okay, similarly for phase spectrum, theta versus omega, it is pi by 2, minus pi by 2, 0, minus pi by 4, minus pi by 2, and these are the values of omega, 0 plus a plus omega like this, minus a minus omega like this, right? So this is the these are the magnitude and phase spectrums for the given problem. Is it clear? So based on the given problem, based on the conditions only we have to solve the problem. If we are not clear about these conditions, the problem may be wrong. Your approach may be wrong. So depend upon these conditions, we will solve this problem. Okay, we'll go to the next problem. Okay, see the next problem. Find the continuous spectrum of non-periodic signal x of t is equal to e power minus a mod t. Here carefully observe this problem. So x of t is equal to e power minus a into mod t for a is greater than 0. Okay, for a is greater than 0, right? See, x of t is equal to e power minus a into mod t for a is greater than 0 is the given
problem. There is no u of t here.
There is no u of t given here, right? So what is meant by mod t? It is plus or minus t, right? So we can expand this as x of t is equal to e power minus a into minus t into u of minus t plus e power minus a t into u of t. Here u of t and u of minus t are by default. We have to consider these u of t and u of minus t by default, right? So if it is e power minus a into minus t, this is the response. If it is e power minus a t into u of t, this is the response. Okay, so this is the entire response of e power minus a mod t, where a is greater than 0, right? Clear? Okay, right. So now we will find out the Fourier transform of this function. So what is the formula for finding the Fourier transform of this function? That is integral minus infinity to infinity x of t into e power minus j omega t dt. What is x of t here? This entire function is x of t, right? So we can write this as integral minus infinity to infinity e power minus a into minus t into u of minus t plus e power minus a t into u of t into whole into e power minus j omega t dt. So multiply e power minus j omega t with this function and this function, right? So if it is u of minus t, u of minus t is varying from minus infinity to zero only. If it is u of t, it is varying from zero to infinity only. So here the limits will change. So minus infinity to zero, e power minus a into minus t into u of minus t into e power minus j omega t dt plus integral zero to infinity e power minus a t into u of t into e power minus j omega t dt, right? Right? So now minus infinity to zero, here the u of minus t value is 1. From 0 to infinity, u of t value is 1. So we can write this as e power minus into minus plus, that is e power a t into e power minus j omega t dt plus integral 0 to infinity e power minus a t into e power minus j omega t dt. It is in the form of e power x into e power y, e power a plus e power x plus y. It is also in the form, in the same form, that is e power x plus y. So here t is common, that's why taking t is common, a minus j omega e power. Similarly, here also t is common, minus t, take minus t as common, a plus j omega, okay, dt. So in the same manner, in the before problem we solved. So in the same manner, we will solve this problem. We will get the value of x of omega as 1 by a minus j omega plus 1 by a plus j omega, taking LCM. So it will become 2a by a square plus omega square. After that, we have to write the expressions for magnitude and phase. So magnitude m can be expressed as mod of x of omega, that is 2a by square root of a square plus omega square. Similarly, here there is no imaginary term. Is there any imaginary term here, j term or I term? No, there is no imaginary term. If imaginary term is not there, then phase angle, angle of x of omega equal to minus tan inverse imaginary term by real term. Here the imaginary term is zero, that's why minus tan inverse zero by real term. This entire thing is real term only. This entire thing is real term only, a square plus omega square, okay? Right? So that's why we will write only real term here. There is no imaginary term. Since x of omega is real, there is no phase spectrum exists, okay? Right. So for this problem, we will draw only the phase, the frequency spectrum only, or magnitude spectrum only. So taking the values of omega and m. So these are the values. So by substituting these values in this expression, we will get the magnitude spectrum like this. So this is the magnitude spectrum. M versus omega is like this. So this is the magnitude spectrum for the given problem. X of t equal to e power minus a into mod t for a is greater than 0. Okay, is it clear? Right. Now we will go for the next problem. Find the continuous spectrum of a non-periodic gate function. Non-periodic gate function. So it is already given. Phi of t is given. Okay, it is a non-periodic gate function given. So it exists from minus 1 to 1. Its value is 1. Phi of t equal to 1 from minus 1 to 1. Otherwise, it is 0. After 1, it is 0. Up to minus 1, it is also 0. Okay, so based on this given figure, we can write the mathematical expression, right? We can write the mathematical expression. So we can write the mathematical expression as phi of t is equal to 1 for minus 1 is less than or equal to t is less than or equal to 1. Is it clear? If you are clear to write these expressions, then simplification of the problem is very easy. If you are not clear to write the expressions from the given figure, it will be little bit difficult. So entire procedure will be wrong if you take the wrong consideration from the diagram. Okay, so first of all, take care about writing the mathematical expressions from the given figure. Okay, so phi of t equal to 1 for minus 1 is less than or equal to t is less than or equal to 1 and is 0 elsewhere, right? So now we will find the Fourier transform for phi of t, that is phi of omega. So phi of omega is equal to Fourier transform of phi of t, right? Fourier transform of phi of t. It is varying from minus 1 to 1. So integral minus 1 to 1 phi of t into e power minus j omega t dt, right? Or it is, we can expand this like this also. This above expression like this also. We can split this above expression as integral minus 1 to 0 phi of t into e power minus j omega t plus integral 0 to 1 phi of t into e power minus j omega t, right?
So,
at anyhow, whatever the procedure you followed, you will get the same figure, this figure as the answer, right? So integral minus 1 to 1 phi of t into e power minus j omega t, here phi of t value is 1 from minus 1 to 1. So it is 1 into e power minus j omega t. So it is e power minus j omega t by j omega. So j 1 by j omega extracted it outside. So into e power minus j omega minus e power j omega. So we have to substitute the values of omega or t at here. So t values are 1 and minus 1. Okay. 1 and minus 1. So this will become 2 by omega into e power j omega minus e power minus j omega by 2j. How you will get this expression? How you will get this expression? So here we are multiplying this expression 1 by minus 1 by j omega minus 1 by j omega into e power minus j omega minus e power j omega by 2 and divide this expression by 2. Multiply and divide this expression by 2 so that we will get this expression 2 by omega into e power j omega minus e power minus j omega by 2j. Okay. Since why we are converting this above expression like this, as we have the formula for sine theta, that is sine theta is equal to e power j theta minus e power minus j theta by 2j. It is a trigonometric formula. Sin theta equal to e power j theta minus e power minus j theta by 2j. It is in the form of e power j theta minus e power minus j theta by 2j. So here at the place of theta we have omega. So it will become sin omega. So sin omega equal to e power j omega minus e power minus j omega by 2j. So this entire expression can be replaced by sin omega. So it is 2 by omega into sin omega. Right? Right. So magnitude m, is there any imaginary term here? No, there is no imaginary term. If there is no imaginary term, then there is no phase spectrum exists. So only we have magnitude spectrum. So magnitude m is equal to 2 by omega into sin omega. By taking the values of omega and m and simply substitute these values in this expression so that we will get the magnitude spectrum like this. Okay. This is the magnitude spectrum 0, pi by 2, pi, 2 pi, 3 pi, 3 pi by 2, like this. These are the omega values so that we will get the m values at here. Okay, is it clear? So, this is the given function. From this function, we have to write the mathematical expression, right? We have to write the mathematical expression, that is phi of t equal to 1. Or minus 1 is less than or equal to t is less than or equal to 1. Okay. Or it is 0 otherwise. Okay. So from this, we can expand or we will solve this problem so that we will get the phi of omega is equal to 2 by omega into sin omega or magnitude. Since there is no imaginary term here, that's why there is no phase spectrum edges. So magnitude, only we have the magnitude, that is magnitude m equal to 2 by omega into sin omega, right? By simply substituting the omega values in this magnitude expression so that we will get the magnitude spectrum like this. Okay, next we will go for the next problem. find the continuous spectrum of see we are solving the different type of problems, each problem from one model. Okay, different type of problems we are solving, right? So now we will find out the continuous spectrum of non periodic signal x of t, which is as shown like this, which is as shown as he see here. So this is the diagram. Here the diagram. This is the diagram. How to write the mathematical expression from this diagram? X of t is given. Here the magnitude from minus infinity minus tau to zero. Here the amplitude is a, or magnitude is a. From zero to tau. Here the amplitude is minus a. From this diagram, how to write the mathematical expressions? So x of t equal to capital A for minus tau is less than or equal to t is less than or equal to 0. That is a one expression. And it is minus A for 0 is less than or equal to t is less than or equal to tau. Otherwise, it is 0. From after B and tau, its value is 0. Up to minus tau, its value is also 0. It is also somewhat looking like the earlier problem, looking like it is same as that of the earlier problem. But in the earlier one, we have given only one pi of t value is equal to 1 from minus 1 to 1. But here, x of t is given as a from minus tau to 0, and it is given as minus a from 0 to tau, right? Remaining places, its value is 0, x of t is 0. Now we have to find the Fourier transform for this problem. Okay? See, x of omega equal to Fourier transform of x of t. That is x of t. Here we have two expressions for x of t. So it is minus infinity to infinity x of t in t power minus j omega t dt is the formula for Fourier transform. So here are the limits. Now we will substitute these limits. Minus tau to 0, its value is a, x of t is a, into e power minus j omega t dt, plus integral 0 to tau minus a, x of t value is minus a, into e power minus j omega t dt, right? So here a and minus a both are constant terms. So drag it outside. So drag it a can be dragged here. Into e power minus j omega t with limits 0 minus tau. So e power minus j omega t by minus j omega with 0 minus tau. Plus a into e power minus j omega. Here actually minus is there. E power minus j omega t by minus j omega. Minus into minus. Minus into minus. Minus in minus gets cancelled and it will become plus. So a into e power minus j omega t by j omega with limits 0 tau. Okay. So it is equal to a into, by substituting the values of 0 and minus 2 at here, it will become like this. And here also, by tau and 0, by substituting the values of tau and 0 at here, this will become this expression. Okay. Now, by simply substituting these values, by adding these two, minus 2 by j omega into e power j omega tau plus e power minus j omega tau by j omega. Okay, j omega LCM, by taking LCM for this one. So simply it is also by taking 2 as common, 2a, it is 2a by j omega into minus 1 plus e power j omega tau plus e power minus j omega tau by 2. Why we are taking 2 as common here? We have a formula for this one. E power j theta plus e power minus j theta by 2 is nothing but cos theta. Whereas in the earlier problem, we have a formula. E power j theta minus e power minus j theta by 2j is nothing but sine theta. Okay? So here also, for cos theta, e power j theta plus e power minus j theta by 2, there is no j term in the denominator for cos theta. Remember. Okay? So e power j theta plus e power minus j theta by 2. Okay? So it is also looking like the same problem. So it is 2j by, here simply we are substituting, here we are multiplying and divide this expression by j, so that it will become j 2a by j into j omega. Why? Because j into j becomes j square equal to minus 1. Okay, j square becomes minus 1. So it is a minus into minus plus. So 1 minus cos theta, cos j omega, cos omega tau. Here theta value is omega tau. Okay, so j 2a by omega into 2, it can be written as 2 times 2 sine square omega tau by 2. Why? Because here it is in the form of 2 sine square x is equal to 1 minus cos 2x. Okay, 2 sine square x is equal to 1 minus cos 2x. So converting this expression into this expression, that is 2 sine square, here there is no 2, that's why it will become by 2. Okay, sine square omega tau by 2, right? So then therefore x of omega becomes j omega tau square into sinc square sin c square, sinc square of omega tau by 2 pi. Why? Because we have a formula for sinc x, that is sinc x is equal to sin pi into x by pi x, sin pi into x by pi x. So here also we can write this by sinc omega tau by 2 pi. So for our simplification purpose only, we are converting this expression into this expression. We can simply up to here we can solve, leave it up to here, no problem. We can leave it up to here, no problem. For our simplification purpose only, we will convert this into this expression. Okay, maximum possible simplification we will do here. Okay, so j 2a by omega into 2 sin square omega tau by 2. So sinc of x is equal to sin pi into pi by x by pi x. So finally, in terms of sinc function, this Fourier transform x of omega is equal to j omega tau square into sinc square of omega tau by 2 pi. Okay, so this is the solution for the above problem. Right? Is it clear? So already we discussed 4 problems here. So we have to write the mathematical expressions from the given problem. If the mathematical expression is correct, definitely your problem will be and your approach will be correct. Otherwise, it will be wrong. Okay? So be cautious while writing the expressions, mathematical expressions from the given figure. Okay, so okay, now we will conclude the today's session. We will close the today's session with these 4 problems. Next, in the next class, we will do some other problems. Okay, thank you.